to the police visit. Oh my gosh, they sure do enter the house quickly. You know, I thought there was a like laws. Anyway, but anyway, my gosh, practically said my husband, my father, is just like, whoa. He's kind of happy with the whole thing. You know, he'll be happy if I go to prison. He'll be happy if I go to sanitarium. Just as long as I am caged and fed. Okay, so we have this caged and fed syndrome, being happy by my father, because my father wants me cared for. So we're dealing with this opulent decision to keep his little daughter, the cared for doll. Now when you have a doll child, well, we don't say a child, we'll say when you have a doll, you know, you go back to your childhood and you're looking at the shelf, you know, where do you put your doll? How do you treat your doll? You know, did you have a brother that didn't like dolls? You know, so we're going back to the doll syndrome in the brain of a child. You know, how did you keep those little objects? Were you nice to them? Did you brush their hair? Did you throw them across the room? How did you treat your little dolls? Is there resentment because it is a doll? And maybe you like it secretly? You know, is there homophobic resentment? So we have all of these builds again and again and again, you know. So here I am, the little doll, caged. You know, is the request caged? So, and so in this opulent of decision of how the little doll is to be kept, there's the, what do we call it, the ease of a phone call, the ease of a phone call to the authorities, provincial, locality, way quick, you know, way quick. Again and again and again. So, anyway, at this point it's become a neighborhood harassment cycle. So when we're dealing with a neighborhood harassment cycle, I believe the neighbors can coordinate a lawsuit against the local municipality. They can sue because there have been so many incidences here, building a reputation that lowers their property prices. Okay. So we're looking at a neighborhood lawsuit, not against me, not against any of this coordination of keeping the doll, how you keep your doll daughters, men, how do you keep your doll daughters? Because all of you, you know, you have your own little weirdnesses with how you keep females. But yeah, so we're dealing with the drama. The drama of those dolls, the drama of the acceleration status of a lawsuit against the municipality. Because when you have, what do you call it, an inordinate amount of unnecessary, not even a telephone call, we're talking visits in vehicles, strutting around in all of their equipment, you know, when we're talking about this going on over silly organization to cage a daughter securely, so she is fed, so she has free income. When you are talking this again and again and again and again, rather than, well, my gosh, you know, maybe she should be a teacher. Maybe we have a whole bunch of facilities there, college she can teach. She invented perpetual motion. She can teach a science class. Why don't you give her free teaching up the hill? She can go teach at the college. I'm not understanding any of the logic why the insistence of the belief of an old man who likes the keep of a daughter, how? As a doll, how? You know, the treatment of a doll, how? And no, I'm not waiting until he dies to talk. I'm not waiting till he dies to speak. Absolutely not, because that is a win. You understand? That is a miss. That is a miss of the current state of the situation. That is a look back at those, oh my God, it was great. You know, it was not a bad life. No. No. Relationships happen in the here and now. They don't happen in the past of oh, it was better than I thought, you know. That memory, that positive memory, it was better than I thought. No. The decision is to speak now with clarity. All right, here we are, Talk Show America. Men having their doll daughters, their doll situations, how they keep them. And when I think about destruction, you know, like my brothers, you know, if they had destructive tendencies, any of them. Yes, I have one brother who has destructive tendencies. Not necessarily to women, but to artwork, his own artwork. You know, so all of these things, you know, you have to look at why. You know, these are all things back into your childhood. Why? You know, are you going to continue it your whole life? You know? Continue it your whole life. You know, is a perfection organism? Is it a perfection organism? That there is the artwork, it was never good enough. Sabotage it. Or there's the doll, not good enough. Sabotage it. So we're dealing with this type of drama, and well, yeah, and so then now they put me on the list and they call me a terrorist. And I'm like, well, yes, technically I am in France. A terrorist is a person who raises fruits and vegetables, legumes they call them. Now, unfortunately, that in this local provincial reality, they don't understand, perhaps. They don't understand that languages, they'll have one word that means another word. You know, you say terroriste, that means farmer. That means farmer. All right. So, yeah, they're tightly strung here. They're tightly wound. They're small-brained. What's going on? Why are their brains so small? And then I'm like, well, this is a problem, because I've had expansionism, haven't I? I have been all over the world. And so I'm visiting the brains that have been kept in a tight compound. So when you're visiting the brains that have lived in a tight compound, and you are speaking from, we'll look at the planet. They have been living on their own little planet. And so you've been out there, you know, out there and on the ring, the rings are away. You've experienced other. Or you've gone even further and experienced, even, I mean, some people I know have been to China and lived there. I mean, how wonderful. But I mean, different, really far out there, you know. So there you go. Way, way, way. So when all of this is going on, there's that misunderstanding. You know, we have words, we have languages, misunderstanding. Just like the word war, the spelling of it in German is war here in America, here in the Britain, war. Es war. It's war? No. It was. Just it was. So now I have this ridiculous contribution from the outer realm. The outer realm, you know, just like an aroma of a bouquet of the outer realm, contribution to the little flower state here. But it's not understood. It's naysayed. It's preferred to only know what's there, this little tiny flower growing here in this little municipality. Just like that doll on the shelf. Exactly just like that doll on the shelf. It never moves. It's never supposed to go to the outer realm. We can punish it now, it's back. What is that, the Barbie Ken syndrome time frame? I mean, we had, what do we call it? Lots of those toys out there. They had the, the dream houses. They had all of these things going on. So all of these scenarios, you know, I've seen terrible treatments to Kens. I've seen Kens with their heads cut off. I go to a friend's house or a young cousin's house, and I'm like, what's going on? You know, what? I wouldn't say anything out loud because, my God, what a destructor. What a destroyer. I mean, so we have women taking these little dolls, these young children, girls, taking these young dolls that are men and destroying them. We have the young girls just not treating their dolls beautifully. Why should they, you know? It's almost like just a constant reflection of themselves. Their give up. Their hatreds at their father. They see that Ken. No, good heavens, who cares about him, you know? Dirty soil his pants or whatever. Who cares about him? Leave him over there in the dust. Magic markers on Ken. I mean, oh my gosh. I mean, it's just ridiculous. It's ridiculous what's happened when you go into the doll syndrome and how you yourself, your natural habit to keep a doll. Your natural habit. And how that reflects with how you interact and how you keep people. Because in essence, we do all keep people. We all do it. I keep people this way, or I keep people that way, or these certain types of people I keep that way. You know, in my mind, I hold that keep of them. That particular ordinance. So yeah. Dang. Dang, yeah. So I'm a farmer, and I suppose this is also cute, because we do have, back to the drudgery of computer machine, we do have the wonders of every word I say on this machine is transcribed into other, it's trans, what do you call it, translated. So my, if I say in French, it'll be translated into English, so English can read what I said. So the machine goes into it that way, or vice versa. If I say in English, it goes into French, and the French can read what I said. So we have all of these cute little nifty tools now. All right. So anyway. So I'm gearing up to teach class. I'm gearing up to teach some class here, some tempura. I really think tempura, I'll go with that. Or the science, or both. I should also teach government class as well. Somebody should be giving me, what do you call it, that lifetime professorship because of my inventions. My inventions offered to science. But anyway, in happiness, I'm dealing with my tempuras right now. And so that's what we're going to do. I'm building up to somehow get myself matriculated as a teacher, since I can't get out of here, the Bay Area. I'll try to get myself matriculated as a teacher. There's dance also. And yes, there's opera. I can sing, I can teach opera. But I don't know. Maybe science is really more important. Yeah. So anyway, I have a full syllabus for a semester course. So I'm kind of excited about it over the tempuras. Very excited. And I think I'll get enough students. Yeah, it's a mean medium. That's all I can say. But yeah, so let's stay aware of the translation aspects of these videos. The transcribing of them into other languages. Let's keep that as in our brains. Anyway, I'm being hollered at. But in the time frame of something else, I had to say there was something else. I wanted to talk about teeth really quickly, but they are healthy growing mechanisms on their own. I just saw a wonderful woman. Yeah, I'm just being hassled. So anyway, they're wonderful growing mechanisms on their own, and minerals. And so, my goodness, I'm not going to seal the tooth that I was trying to get repaired. I'm going to go with the natural methodology. So look it up, silica and oil. Some kind of a food oil on the tooth. All right.